This is Kirk Mathew Gatzka again, and we're going to use Cam Studio Recorder to show you how to auto paint a picture. And you can see that we're selecting an autumn pathway. As we select that picture, then we open it with PaintNet, and with PaintNet, we're going to make some adjustments. Here we select the adjustments, and then we go to curves, and then we select from luminosity, we go to RGB. And we lighten the picture a bit, and okay that, save that, and that lightens the colors a bit. And then we go to hue and saturation, and we boost the saturation from 100 to 110. That's okay. And then we're going to be saving this file. We save it as, and then we save it in a location that we'll know where to return to it. We give it a new name. As you can see, we're typing out the new name now. It's an autumn-based picture of a pathway between trees, so we're going to use the term autumn in it for the name, and then we're going to save that. And as we're working on this, we'd like to express our happiness that you're joining us and watching this with us. This is sped up a little bit. It's slower than what I thought it was going to be in recording, but I can speed it up a little bit faster, but then my recording would be quicker. And now we have the basis for the 100% file saving. It'll give us the clearest picture. It saves it. And then we actually go to the spot where we saved it at with the new name. And we're going to open it up with another program in just a few minutes to show you how we can auto-paint that program. We're creating a new folder here, and we're going to call it Pathways, I believe, if I remember correctly. And then when we correctly type in the name, then we'll take the picture of the autumn pathway, and we're going to move it to Pathways. So it'll be easy for us to find. And then we just click on Pathways, and there's the picture, our autumn pathway that we just made adjustments to. Now we're switching to another animation that we're joining together with the beginning one, the part one, Pathways Part 1. And now we have Pathways Part 2, and we're using Cam Studio Recorder, and we're going to be selecting Painter Essentials 5, which comes from Corel. We're loading that up, and you'll notice at the top it says it's not responding, and then it responds. I'm not sure why that happens. I think it has to do with linking up with the internet, and then the opening page comes open afterwards. It's working fine, so I haven't tried to find out what the problem is with that. But I'm going to the Pathways folder that I created earlier under my 2016 Gatzkart folder, and go to Pathways, and I'm going to open up the autumn pathway that we just had changed in paint.net, and now there we'll see the painting. And here we're going to select, this time I believe it's oil painting, and we select that, and then we're going to use that image. As you can see, it makes the one blank, and we're going to select from the acrylics and oils. You can see the different types of brushes, and we're picking a brush from there, It's the opaque brush. And then we're going to auto paint it. We click on start. And Painter Essentials 5 begins to paint the picture. And as we watch this, we can see that it's automatic. Again, I am not painting this with my hands or with my Wacom or Wacom, excuse me, tablet. I'm allowing the program to actually paint the picture as an oil painting. And this will create the picture that we want to have to show how we can do this with the Painter Essentials 5. And it will be a basic oil painting with a basic brush that was a smaller, thinner brush. The settings were shown on the top of the screen, what brush we chose, and also the settings for the brush. And this is taking a little bit longer than I thought. It's about 7 minutes long, I believe, and with the other paint net adjustments created, it will create quite a long MP4 project, and we may speed that up and we may not. So we appreciate your patience in watching. Here it's still painting. You can see that it makes the brushes smaller and smaller, and the detail comes out clearer and clearer. And then we will be selecting the soft cloner brush when it's done painting this, and we'll brush in some detail, which we will show in just a few moments, where the detail will be enhanced by the soft cloner brush. So we'll wait till the oil painting is done, and it's still doing it automatically. Again, I'm not painting this. It's auto-painted by the program, Painter Essentials 5. And I think that it's a good product. I do have Painter 11, but for some reason, because I have the Essentials as well, it will not allow me to reinstall Painter 11 on Windows 10, which is a disappointment because I enjoy being able to paint in Painter 11. But I can do many of the same things that I did in Painter 11 with Painter Essentials 5, although I do enjoy using the auto paint feature quite a bit. So here's our oil painting finishing up. It continues to get smaller and smaller brushes, and now it's completed, as you can see. Now we're going to select the soft cloner brush. As you see up in the upper left-hand corner, we're going to go and select the soft cloner brush from the photo painting brushes. And we're going to take that and we're going to stroke in some detail into the branches to help make them stand out a little bit more clearly in the painted oil painting, especially the one that goes across the center of the pathway. And there you see that it was looking for my external drive, which was not there. So we're adjusting this as we go with the strokes of the soft cloner, adding back in some detail to different parts of this painting. And I think that you'll appreciate the fact that you can do this quite easily. And then we're going to save this as a JPEG. It's normally in a RIF which is which was the proprietary format for Painter Essentials. You notice that the autumn painting now says painter painting on it, and we're going to save that, and it will show us the detail in the painting. You can see all the paint brush strokes as we scroll through, and there's some of the area where we use the soft cloner, and here's the large portion of the painting that we're looking at now. We take care of that, and we're going to be saving it, and that's how you do that with Painter Essentials. And now we're stopping with camcorder. So thank you.